Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to one and all. And I welcome you all to the 45th meeting of Toastmaster for Hyderabad Entrepreneurs. Toastmaster meeting is where we develop ourselves and try to become a better version of what we were yesterday. Let's exhibit this by following few ground rules. Keep your any sound making noise device off, phone, or it can be anything. Try to stay in a quiet location if you are going to speak today. Try to avoid cross chatting or cross talking so that you are not disturbing the speaker on the stage today. And whenever you are speaking, try to avoid any subjects on sex, religion, or politics in a discriminatory manner, so as you might land up hurting somebody's feeling. And that's not what Toastmaster stands for. As you respect everybody's feelings or everybody's understanding about these topics, especially. With that note, I announce meeting officially open and pass the control to our presiding officer, Toastmaster Kalpana.
Thank you, TTM Raku. Once again, welcome one and all for an exciting meeting of Toastmaster for Hyderabad Entrepreneurs, meeting number 45. I hope I am audible. Clear? Yes. Okay. Thank you. So I see we have all the persons in the group are Toastmasters. Nelson, may I know, are you a Toastmaster?
I can't hear you.
I'm not able to hear you.
He's a guest.
Okay. Thank you. I just wanted to know if you are from any other club. Okay, for the benefit of guests and non-Toastmasters, let me tell you the details of Toastmasters. Toastmasters is an international non-profit organization which helps various people from different backgrounds to improve their communication and leadership skills. We have 140 countries which have more than 1,600 clubs and 3 lakh people associated with each club who develop their communication and leadership skills. I hope we will all get to improve our communication and leadership skills. Nelson, I remember I saw you previously also in one of the special meetings that we have. So please let us know what is your plan to join Toastmasters? When are you planning to join?
Probably I was postponing for the past 2-3 months, I think. I'm just in a spectator. Anyway, try to join next month, Raghu. I'll make it sure that I'll be joining next month. Yeah.
Sure.
Thank you for having me. Because anyway, I'm enjoying. I'm taking so much of insights from joining this Toastmasters. I enjoy it.
Thank you, Nelson. We look forward for you to join our group. We have Giri today. Giri, welcome. I know you are a visiting Toastmasters and regular member visitor of our club. Thanks for joining with us today. Guest Kiran.
Hi. Good evening, everybody, all Toastmasters. Thanks for me getting this opportunity to join this meeting. I am from the Storytellers. So it's great to be part of your team here. Yeah.
Welcome. And we are looking forward to take your feedback, and we'll ensure that you'll have a entertaining meeting today. With this, I would like to pass on the control to this lady who loves to take up challenges and whose hobby is to watch Cartoon Network, and by profession she is a project manager at one of the IT companies. So I welcome Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Shweta.
Thank you, Kalpana, for the intro. A small correction, I am not a project manager, I am a project engineer. It's been 1 year I joined the organization. Good morning.
I wish you'll soon become project manager.
Thank you. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Welcome to 45th meeting of Toastmasters for Hyderabad Entrepreneurs. I am Sai Sweta, your host for today. Now let me explain the program for the benefit of the guests. We have three sessions today. The first session will consist of a prepared speech where the speaker will deliver his or her speech that is based on certain objective from their project. And the second session will be impromptu speaking or the table topics. In this session, you will learn how to think fast and speak off the cuff. And the third session will be evaluation of prepared speech by senior members who will give feedback to the speakers. And there will be voting and we'll choose best speaker, evaluator, and role player of the day. Before I introduce role players, let me introduce theme of the day, importance of feedback. Bill Gates once said, "We all need people who will give us feedback. That's how we improve." And it's true. Effective feedback helps individuals to understand what they did well and what they could do better. Let me ask you a question. Any of you felt bad of when you faced any negative feedback?
See, generally, right? See, sometimes, even though it is true, right, when you get a feedback, you might need to improve in the area where they're given a feedback. Sometimes you feel hard because, like, some of them will be straightforward things where you feel a bit of back. You are made back there and you got a feedback. But what I feel is, based on my experience, what I feel is, you have to take this feedback in a positive attitude manner and go ahead and get it done, the things which you have gaps there. That's what I felt. Based on my experience, that's what I could see there, actually.
Yeah, thank you, Kiran, for your words. Actually, when someone give us positive feedback or constructive feedback, it will make the person as they're in the seventh heaven, right? And when we get the destructive or negative feedback, and it will make the person down in the dumps. Like, I feel personally, when someone give positive feedback, we won't think like, is this correct? Are they bluffing? We won't think. If someone says, Sweta, you're very good at communication, I will say, oh, thank you. And I will feel happy the entire day remembering that. They said I am communicating good, like that. If someone say your vocabulary is bad, Sweta, though I know my vocabulary is good or maybe I can learn, but I will feel like, my vocabulary is bad. The entire day will get spoiled. For me, it will happen like that. Maybe to most of the people as humans, everyone will face this. And I feel negative feedback is like a rocket. Like anywhere in the world, negativity is like a rocket. It will go just like that. And whereas positivity is like a bicycle, it will go slowly. And there are two aspects of feedback that I consider which need to be mentioned. The first one is how we are giving feedback. And the second one is how we are taking the feedback. So when we are expecting someone to give a feedback in a constructive way, which is not like, we can tell negative thing, like if my grammar is bad, that's fine, I can learn. So we should tell in a way like, Sweta, you're speaking well, but you can do better with your grammar. But we should not say, hey, you're not talking properly. All grammatical mistakes. Did you study in English medium school only? this is something sarcastic and which will distract that person completely. So with this, let me go to introduction of my team, and I will continue this in the session later on. The first one is Sergeant at Arms. He is DTM Raghu, who is a nomadic toastmaster in pursuit of excellence. He already opened the meeting bank on time, and throughout the meeting, he will guide gate to ensure no one in the meeting is disturbed. Thank you, Raghu, for the grand opening. And let me introduce General Evaluator, Toastmaster Nikhila, who is an IT professional. Over to you, Toastmaster Nikhila. You can introduce your team. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster of today, Shweta. Hi, everyone. Good evening. I am Nikhila, and I am today's General Evaluator. As a General Evaluator, I will evaluate complete meeting proceedings. To help me in this process, I have a team of timer, counter, and grammarian with me. I introduce timer TM Kalpana to come and explain her role. Over to you, TM Kalpana.
Thank you, General Evaluator Toastmaster Nikhila. Hi all, once again I'm back with a new role, timer. We all know how much money we have in our pockets. We don't know how much time we have with us. So here I am to help you, but to tell you how much time you have to end your speech. Whenever you are in your correct minimum time zone, I will raise and flash a green card at back of my, as a background. Once you are about to reach to the maximum time, I will raise the amber card or yellow card. And when you reach the maximum time, I will raise the red card as my background. And once the red card is flashed, there will be a 30 seconds of grace period given to all the timers. I'll give my timer report whenever General Evaluator calls me back. Today, we have prepared speech segment where we have special speech of 15 minutes and 5 to 7 minutes. And for the table topics, we will have minimum time of 1 minute, maximum of 2 minutes. And for the evaluation, we have 2 minutes as the minimum time and 3 minutes as the maximum time. Thank you. Over to the General Evaluator.
Small correction to Shwasha Kalpana. Both the speeches will be 5 to 7 minutes.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for that.
Thank you, Kalpana. I introduce grammarian of the day, TM Manasa, to come and introduce her role.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nikhila. Mr. and Madam Toastmaster and the fellow Toastmasters and guests, as a grammarian, it is my responsibility to pay close attention to all the speakers by listening carefully to their language usage. And I'll also take note of any improper language as well as any outstanding words, quotes, sayings, or thoughts. So as a grammarian, I'm going to introduce the word of the day and the idiom of the day. So for today's meeting, the word of the day is plaudit. So the meaning is an expression of praise or approval. So example of this word of the day is, he is totally dedicated to others and deserves every plaudit for the work he does. So when it comes to the idiom of the day, it is up to snuff. The meaning is meeting the required standard. So example of this idiom is, I'm not quite sure if your work has been up to snuff lately. Is everything all right? So each speaker is actually encouraged to use the word of the day and the idiom of the day. So I'll give the grammarian's report when I'm called during the meeting, and I also report on the usage of the word of the day and the idiom of the day. Thank you, Mr. and Madam Toastmaster.
Thank you, Manasa. I introduce TM Indira, counter of the day, to come and explain her role.
Thank you, General Evaluator. Good evening, Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters, and my dear guests. I'm Toastmaster Indira. My role as the R counter is to count the number of unnecessary sounds or repetitive words you may use when you are speaking during the meeting. I'll be observing and taking note of words such as like, these are filler words that affect the effectiveness of speech. At the end of the meeting, I will present my report when called upon by the General Evaluator. Back to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Indira. I also have speech evaluators as a part of team, whom I will introduce at a later part. And I will submit my report when the Toastmaster of the day calls upon the stage. Over to you, TMOD. Thank you.
Thank you, Nikhila. Before going to the next session, prepared speeches, let us just play a small game, a very small game, in which take a paper and pen. I will give you a word, I will give you a string. You need to form the substrings for all the possible substrings in 30 seconds. So it's just an exercise to cheer further. Okay. Is everyone ready? Okay. When 30 seconds is over, I will tell just stop. Okay. And the first word is feedback. Your time starts now. I'll repeat once again, possible substrings. From feedback, how many other words you can form? Stop. Did anyone wrote more than 10? No, more than 5? No. Is that much tough? Okay. Let's try another one. Just another one. If we have time only.
We can take one.
Yeah. We can take Happy Halloween. So it's a something big word. You can find subwords. Happy Halloween. And your time starts now. Yeah, stop. Now, anyone more than 10? Oh, no one.
I wrote 10.
Okay, can you tell those?
I hope I'm right. Hollow, hen, hall, allow, have, low, we, happy, hello.
Okay, excellent, Kalpana. And you won the show. Just a small show. So with this, let me start with the next session and the first session. Prepared speeches. Our first speaker is TM Toastmaster Claudimir, if I am not wrong. Toastmaster Claudimir will be attempting level 3 project connect with storytelling. He is an engineer and he postgraduated in neuroscience and behavior. He likes reading books and he is passionate about human nature. I request his evaluator, Toastmaster Bhavini, to read the objectives of his speech. Tell us the time limit and title of the speech. Over to you, Bhavini.
Thank you, Toastmaster. Thank you. You were getting cut off in between, but I'll start. So like you said, Toastmaster Claudimir, if I'm pronouncing it correctly, will be delivering his level 3 speech today about connect with storytelling. And his speech title is, It is Never Too Late. And his speech duration is going to be 5 to 7 minutes. Looking forward to listening to you. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Bhavini. Please help me welcome Toastmaster Claudimir. Title, It is Never Too Late. It is never too late, Cloudmere. Over to you, Cloudmere.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Every Sunday, two brothers talk to each other. A younger brother and a elder brother. Every Sunday, the elder brother wanted to help the little brother to be successful as he was in the multinational companies. And then the elder brother said, if I could give you just one tip, the tip for you to be successful is speak English fluently. The younger brother understood it, but he was too young to really feel the importance of it. And the elder brother said, I will pay an English school for you because it is very important. The younger brother started going to the English school, but he didn't like studying English. He felt that he couldn't learn it. It was too difficult for him. And then, instead of going to the English school, the younger brother chose to visit friends, to play soccer, to do whatever was possible except study English. But the elder brother, every Sunday during the family lunch, asked him, do you already speak English fluently? And the younger brother said, no, I'm studying. I will get there. But that was not true because the younger brother wasn't studying. And the next Sunday, the elder brother came again and said, and asked him actually, do you already speak English fluently? And the younger brother replied, no, I'm still studying. But that wasn't true. 10 years passed. 10 years passed. And the younger brother was working in an international company, in a multinational company. And he wanted to apply for a position, to a higher position, if in the company. And he applied. And when the day of the interview came, the first question he was asked was by the interviewer, do you speak English fluently? And the younger brother, that was not younger at that time, after 10 years, asked, yes, I do. But that was not true. And what happened? He missed the opportunity. And he couldn't get the job he wanted. The younger brother felt so frustrated. He felt pain because he missed that great opportunity in his life, because he didn't speak English fluently. And then he decided to not be a loser in his life. He went to London, stayed there for a month, studied English, came back to his country, studied hard, paid two English schools, one in person and another online, a virtual format. And he studied really hard. Fellow Toastmasters and guests, that little boy, it's me. And I'm proud to be here speaking English in this international club with great people. But more than that, today is Sunday, and my elder brother you come here to have lunch with me. And he's gonna ask me, do you speak Italy? And now I can say, I do speak Italy. And your brother, my elder brother, thank you for believing me. It's never too late to learn something. Thank you, fellow Toastmasters.
Thank you, Vladimir. It's a wonderful speech. Let us pause for 2 minutes to write feedback for the speaker. Like you can share feedback through chat or you can tell him. Okay, let's begin. Let's continue with the next speaker. Toastmaster Raghu. Sorry. Timer, please give the report.
No, you need to call Rupali to give the speech objectives.
Okay. Toastmaster Raghu, who is a nomadic Toastmaster in Pursuing of Excellence. Toastmaster Raghu will be attempting Project 3 from Level 1. I request his evaluator, Toastmaster Rupali, to read the objectives of his speech. Tell us the time limit and title of the speech. Over to you, Rupali.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. So, Toastmaster Raghu will be delivering his Level 2 Project 1 speech on the topic Walk the Talk. His speech limit will be 5 to 7 minutes. And I am very curious and looking forward for your speech. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Rupali. Now let me welcome, just a moment. Let me welcome our Toastmaster Raghu. His title is Walk the Talk. Walk the Talk, Toastmaster Raghu. Over to you.
Okay, are you able to see me and hear me clearly? Thank you very much. One day, a person went to Mahatma Gandhi. He had a request. A request for Mahatma to tell his son to get rid of a habit of eating jaggery, the other form of sugar, daily. His son used to eat jaggery so much that his health was deteriorating. Mahatma didn't even pay attention. He told his assistant to ask this person to go back, come back after 3 days. The person was puzzled. Why did he even say that? Why didn't he pay even attention to me? But he had his own aura, and then he was famous at that period of time. The person came back after 3 days with his son. Then Mahatma told, "My son, please get rid of this habit, and it's not good for your health at this point of time. And this is the way that you can do." Toastmaster of Day, fellow Toastmasters, and my dear guests. When I hear this story for the first time in my life, it made a lot of difference to me. Walk the talk. Mahatma could have just given the lecture like any other person does, any other politician at that point of time, but he didn't do it. He first took that course. He reflected in his own life. That is the way when he could go and tell that young boy that how he could get rid of that habit. He took 3 days' time to get rid of his own habit of eating jaggery every day, and then he could tell that son, walk the talk. My father was an Air Force officer. If anything, right, I'm thankful to him, is he taught me always to maintain my integrity, speak the truth. My mother has always been a housewife. What did I learn from her was empathy. Empathy towards everyone, irrespective of how educated she was, her, whatever background she came from. People loved her for her empathy, the way that she treated the guests who came to her house, or my friends who were sick at different point of time and had no access to their parents. That made her great. These are the qualities that helped me become a better person, as the leader that I am today. People talk about leadership style in different ways. But one thing I would tell, that everybody, with or without knowing, we are dynamic leaders. The way that we deal with our children, the way that we talk to others, the way that we deal with our clients, the day we deal in office, is separate and different. But one core thing, what matters is your core values that you carry. Are you really faking it, or do you really mean it? That is the difference that makes you a great leader. My first step, or my first, you can say, the hardship that came to me as a leader was when my whole team was fired just with half an hour notice in a company. I hired each one of them as my project, 9 members, and they trusted me for joining in that middle-sized company. More than me, I felt a lot for my team members. What I did that point of time was not just feeling sorry for them. I stood by them, ensured that each and every person finds one or other position in different companies, gave them referrals, whatever necessary was given, even trying few for their interviews. After 9 of them were placed in different companies, I took my position in Bank of America then. That ensured that people remember me till date for my integrity and my service. Affiliative leadership is what I stand for, whether it is personal life or Toastmasters. When I was working towards chartering Toastmasters for Hyderabad entrepreneurs, I worked with few core team members: Toastmaster Sonia, Toastmaster Kalpana, and Toastmaster Avinash, who helped me on the speech craft program. Same time, Toastmaster Ramesh, who was working with me to bring the members. Where necessary, I have used my style of coaching to help people scale up to the level that they need. I also was altruistic when I helped members to tell them to get to the speed with what is necessary. At the same time, I understand people do fail. It is okay to fail. That is what is actually my motto. Because unless you fail, how do you even find improvement areas? I think if my first manager in Bank of America has taught me something good, this is the one. When I was so afraid of people in my team failing, he just told me one thing, Raghu, unless you let people fail, they will not know the value that what you are telling them. So let them fail and then come back to you. That is what has made a lot of difference in me today. Irrespective of anything, in spite of anything, today, if I have made my progress in my leadership journey, is just because of those core values that I came from the stories that I've read, or my parents who have instituted these two, empathy and truth, or integrity. This has been a way too forward in me. And one thing I learned from Toastmasters is excellence. This core value has helped me to work with my members and work myself through a long journey to become the better and the best. Thank you, Toastmaster Day. I am sure that we all do the work that we talk.
Thank you, Raghu. It's an excellent speech. Let us pause for 2 minutes to write feedback from the speaker. Actually, I have a network problem. I'm making sure my audio is clear. That's why I turn off my video. If it is okay, I'll return.
Yeah, you are audible. Right.
Shweta, we finished 1 minute. You may continue.
Thank you. Thank you, Kalpana. Let us continue with the theme, importance of feedback. I want to share my experience now, like my Toastmaster experience. It's been a month I joined Toastmasters, and when I joined first, when I gave my icebreaker speech, everyone gave a big round of applause. Like I was on the seventh hill. Everyone praised me. Wow, Sweta, you did really well. Everyone praised me. And it's the fourth week. I am receiving feedback. Like, you can do this better, Sweta. Like that. Initially, I was unable to take it. I felt like during the first week, everyone told like, my grammar is good, vocabulary is good, I'm presenting well, everything is fine. But when it comes to second speech, why I'm getting feedback like this? And I thought, like, it's a problem with my speech, or did I change anything, or like this. Then someone told, your structure is not good, Sweta. Straightly they told. And that full day I sat and thought, because from my childhood, I'm like a person who just like a table topics. I will just go like that and speak in front of anyone. When I received that feedback, I felt very sad. The first thing that comes to human mind is they don't listen correctly. It's not my fault. It's their fault. We usually do this.
we won't take faults to our side. We'll give faults to someone else and we'll sit relaxed. So I did that to console me. But from then I considered it very seriously. I am not going just like that to speak. Like previously I played Toastmaster of the Day once. Then I just go like that. I kept the names in my phone, the script in my laptop, just like that I went and presented. But after that, I understood, like with the feedback I got, I understood, no, I need to prepare, I need to make a structure and I need to present it well. It's not a school or college that should work. Here, there are so many people who are more experienced. After joining Toastmasters, I am getting feared. Like my fear is so big people, very experienced people. They are good at communication. I am a very little girl who is 22 years old. I don't know anything. If I speak anything wrong, from then I stopped speaking. So many people in my club told, it's okay if you receive negative feedback. You can improve. Speak, they used to tell. And today I came up with preparation. And I understood going without preparation and blaming the negative feedback is not right thing. If I prepare well, if I present it in a good way, if I get a negative feedback, then I can think of the feedback. But without any preparation or if I have mistake from my side, I feel like every time when I give a speech or when I go through something, first I will analyze myself and I write the points which I need to work on. And if someone give me the feedback that is in that one, so I will take it. Oh, first I only identified this than the other person. What I mean to say is, if we, like, I won't say 100% every person is perfect in delivering things or speaking at home. Personally, also we'll face these kind of things. But whenever someone gives you feedback, it's not about how they are giving. It's about how we are receiving. It's all matters. And let us continue with our next session, table topics. To conduct this session, we have
Toastmaster Sweta. We can have the poll and then we can take 5 minutes break.
Oh.
We have the time.
Oh, actually, sorry, I don't know these things.
No problem. That is fine. I'm okay. Launching poll. Please vote for whoever you think did best. Thank you very much. Now we can take 5 minutes break. It's in Indian time, it is 7:44. We can join back by 7:49 p.m. PTM Umesh, you had some question?
No, I just wanted to check my voice is clearly audible.
Yes, clearly audible. Feel free to take a break and come back.
Okay.
to Toastmasters today for I am the table topic master for today's meeting, and my role is to give a small, simple, impromptu topics to everyone. Being a Toastmaster, I start to participate in table topic master as a table topic master, and there are a few rules which I would like to explain. First rule: the time limit. The time limit is 1 to 2 minutes. Timer will show green card at 1 minute, yellow card at 1:30, and red card at 2 minutes. And there will be 30 seconds.
We are not able to hear you, Umesh. Umesh?
Hello.
Yeah, we are able to hear you now. For a moment, we lost your voice.
Umesh, in case you want to stop your video and run the show, it's fine. Just to save the bandwidth.
Raghu, I'm keeping my video off. This is some bandwidth.
Sure, no problem.
You?
No problem. Go ahead. Umesh? Still facing the issue, Umesh? Okay, no problem. While Umesh is trying to figure out, I'll try to run the show for my friend. In our life, we need to talk on the spot. We cannot go prepared for every time, just like this period when our friend is facing an issue with his bandwidth and is unable to talk. There's several situations where you need to talk to your client, your wife especially, and maybe your siblings, your children. There might be several questions, especially when you talk to your senior leadership in the office, several occasions. That is the time when you talk, need to use your impromptu skills, critical thinking, you know, put on time. So we have a special section in Toastmaster which helps you to do better there. It is trivial topics. Now our friend is back. I'll let him take.
My apologies. There is some network issue at my end. Just to give the quick guidelines, the time limit will be 1 to 2 minutes. Your green card will be shown at 1 minute. 1 minute, 30 second yellow card will be shown, and 2 minute red card will be shown. And there will be 30 seconds grace period to sum up your topic. It will be simple and quick topics which will give you to impromptu thinking and how quick you are. It's like a small speech within 2 minutes. I will give Toastmaster name, topic, Toastmaster name. And from your first verbal or non-verbal communication, time will start. So who would like to go first? Kalpana, please help me if anyone is raising hand.
I can go. Bhavini nominated.
Okay. Bhavini, can you check, please, check your audio and video?
Hello, good evening, everyone. Am I properly audible and visible?
Yes,
I can see the time of that too. Yeah. I think we
lost. Yes, you are audible. So, your topic is Toastmaster Bhavini. Good feedback is the key to improvement. Good feedback is key to the improvement. Toastmaster Bhavini.
We all start as underdog in some or the other aspects of a life, be it learning a new sport or starting a new career. When I started my journey as an engineer in an IT firm, I was lost for so many years. I didn't know what I was a part of. I wasn't aware what I was doing and how it was contributing to my team, my project, and the organization that I'm working for. I was clueless for so long. And then I became a senior developer. I became a lead. And now I'm handling a team of 34 people. When I am leading such, you know, young minds, and I was in those shoes a few years ago, I understood what I was missing back then. What I was missing was continuous and constructive feedback from people who are senior to me, from people that I looked up to. It is because of Toastmasters as well that I understood the importance of how to give proper feedback. I schedule regular one-on-ones with my team. I try to understand what are the struggles. I try to commend them on their strongest points, and I try to suggest them and help them how they can improve themselves in technical or non-technical aspects of work and professional life. Toastmasters really help a great deal in understanding the importance of feedback, because it is only continuous feedback that helps you improve yourself one day at a time, one feedback at a time. So everyone here, I would want you to take this message that you should not just, you know, take feedback, but you should also have a receiving feedback mindset, because people can give you feedback, but if you do not apply it, then it goes for waste. So as much as receiving feedback is important, applying the feedback is also much more important. And it has changed my life, and I hope I can change the lives of others that can help, that can benefit from my feedback. Thank you, and over to you.
Thank you, Bhavini, for wonderful thoughts on the feedback. And as you rightly said, that we should be on the same, we should give feedback and we should receive feedback for the improvement. And it is beneficial for both the sides. And how the feedback can help us to grow as well as to whom we are giving feedback. Thank you. Who would like to go next?
Nikhila has raised her hand, Umesh.
Yeah, Toastmaster Nikhila.
Hi, Umesh.
Yeah, you're clearly audible and visible. So seeing at your smile, change, Toastmaster Nikhila, change is the only constant. Change.
I think Umesh got struck.
Is the only constant.
Today, Umesh has become Mr. India.
Sorry. I am extremely sorry. Please bear with me.
Umesh, it's okay. Keep your video off and then continue. Umesh, you there?
Toastmaster. Yeah. Hello.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Toastmaster Nikhila, change is the only constant. Change is the only constant. Toastmaster Nikhila.
Thank you, Umesh. Yeah, change is the only constant. I believe in it. There was a time I was struck. I was afraid of taking or accepting the change. I was in my first company for 6 long years because I was afraid of change. I was afraid of taking new responsibilities. I was afraid of that uncertainty. But one day I realized that until unless you accept the reality that change is the only constant, there is no growth in the life. There is no progress in your life. So when I realized it, I took the step, I took the action, and I joined another organization. And then I understood how important a change is and how it helps you in grow in your life. And and you should accept that, instead of struggling or spending your time not realizing the reality, accept the reality that change is the only constant, and always go for that progress and improve yourself. Yeah, that's from my side. Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you, Toshma. As you rightly said, thank you, Toastmaster Nikhila. As you rightly said, change is the only constant, and we should always look for change, and we should adapt new things. If you are rigid, then we will not be going to improve, and we will not able to grow. Thank you. Who would like to go next? I think there is a guest, Kiran. Can you please unmute yourself?
Yes, Mesh. Yeah. Toastmaster Mesh.
Guest Kiran, a feedback that has made you leader. The feedback that has made you a leader. Guest Kiran.
Yeah. Hi all. The feedback generally, it in my experience, in my life, it helped me a lot. Actually, the situations where I came across in my career aspect or a personal aspect, right? So always see, you will not be 100% in each of the aspects, everything in your life. If you take in a career aspect, I'm a person from a technical background, was technically working on the things in the development of the applications and implementation aspect, but I was never leading the teams or be a leader there, being managing the things. Always I was a individual contributor, but when I took a managerial role, I got any feedbacks from where I am lagging it. Since being a leader is not so simple, right? Because you are accountable to your leader, to your management, where you should be very good at your communication skills as well, where you are able to articulate the things well and able to convince so that you'll be balanced. There, I learned a lot there. I felt like that made me a different, where what does a leader means here? Leader is not just, manager is not a leader here. A leader is a person attitude which makes to influence the people and support the others and make them to their best. So there I feel like feedback helps me a lot in both in personal and as well as in my career aspect. Thank you all.
Thank you, guest Karan, for your thoughts. And as you rightly said, feedback is important to become a good leader, not only the manager, but same time having to grow our team or the reportees to become a good leader. It's like your successful planners. If you give effective feedback, that can change their life.
Yeah, I totally agree on it. Yeah.
To become a good. I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, otherwise I'm going to take a name. 1, 2, 3. I would like to call our AHA counter.
Yeah, hello.
Hello. Toastmaster Indira.
Yeah.
Negative feedback that has impacted on your life. A negative feedback that has impacted on your life. Toastmaster Indira.
Negative impact in my life means I will take only in positive way. Why means negative means there are, I'm learning there to improve myself, negative impact to myself. So I'm getting negative feedback means, so I'm learning, I'm moving forward to learn something. So I take in positive only. If I take any negative feedback from other side, I don't take in negative way to like I depress to myself. I take only myself what I'm learning. I want to put efforts to learn from myself. So I will improve where I'm going negative way. So I will put on my efforts on positive way. So. Thank you.
Thank you, Indira. As you rightly picked up, that whatever negative comes to us, that we should always look from the positive perspective. And whatever negative feedback or whatever negative thoughts, we should able to convert it into positive and make them as a stone or a step for climbing the ladder. The approach was right. We should adapt that approach, because there are situations where we always get negative words, negative comments, or negative situations. But rather than just focusing on the situations, if we convert those into positive, it will do the miracles in our life. There are a few guests. I would like to call upon guest Subhadra. Would you like to go for next topic?
Okay, I'll try.
Okay. Is timer screen is visible to you?
Yes.
It's a simple topic. A wise advice given by your mom. A wise advice given by your mom. Guest Subhadra.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests. It's not, my mother never gave me any advices, except that when I got married, she said, you need to take care of your husband and your husband's family. Except for that, she never gave me any advices. But what I learned from my grandmother, whom I used to treat as my own mother, was how to take care of guests who come to your house. That's what I learned from her. Whenever any guest used to come to my grandmother's house, the first thing she used to do was offer them water. And then if it was summer, she would offer them lassi, salt lassi, because they would have come from the hot sun. And if it was winter, it would have been hot tea. And then she would ask them, did you have your lunch? If not, you can join us. That's exactly what she used to do. And that is what I learned from her. And she advised me, whenever anyone comes to your house, you have to treat them like God. How you treat and how you, when you pray to God, how you treat your God. So in Telugu, there is a saying, Atidi Devo Bhava. So that is exactly what I learned from her, and I follow it to the letter T. Fellow Toastmasters, please remember to look after your guests nicely. when they visit your houses. Thank you very much. Over to you, Table Topic Master.
Thank you, guest Subhadra. It was a wonderful thought. Every mother gives this wise advice, not by saying, but by acting or by demonstrating. The guest is a god, and whatever you can do for your guest or whosoever comes to your house, we should do. And what a symbolic water in normal conditions, and when it is the summer, a salted. So it was a nice gesture. And we, even I believe that we can also adapt that, and not only the guest, but a small or simple smile when we go from outside our home to outside world, maybe watchman, maybe housekeeping people, maybe rickshaw driver, or maybe auto driver, or maybe cab driver, a simple smile and two good words so that they also feel like human being. Thank you, Subhadra, for your wonderful thoughts on that. Now I would like to call upon our evaluator Rupali as the next table topic speaker. Rupali?
Yes.
Toastmaster Rupali, mentor, mentee, feedback. Mentor, mentee, feedback. Toastmaster Rupali.
Okay. So thank you for the topic, Umesh. Mentor, mentee, feedback. We all know we are part of Toastmasters, and for the guests, we all play certain roles in Toastmaster meetings, and it plays around with these words, mentor, mentee, and feedback. And these three words benefits us all in all the way, because someone plays the role of mentor, someone plays the role of mentee, and it helps the mentor to become a better mentor, and it helps the mentee to get the feedback, negative or constructive, positive, whatever it is, to be a better self of them. So I believe all these processes in the Toastmaster meetings and being a Toastmaster really helps in our day-to-day life to achieve better in our lives. To share a small story, I participated in our club contest, and I got the first position in the evaluation contest, and it was my first time experience, and it was achievable because I got a very nice mentor. He was very helpful, and I think the pair of me being his mentee and he being my mentor was truly helped me to win the contest. So yeah, that was mentor, mentee, and feedback. Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Rupali, for your thoughts on the mentor, mentee, and feedback. And that reminded me about my mentor, my first mentor, that how I got to know and how she was pushing me for taking roles in all the meetings. And after every meeting, every weekend, she used to give feedback. That was great. And she inculcated into me that I can be a good mentor. And I'm also thankful to my mentees. Those are making me proud by representing in area contest level. So it's a very different relation, mentor, mentee, and feedback. Feedback is a key that we should trust our mentor and follow and improve upon that. Now I would like to call upon two volunteers. The first one I will choose, Raghu. And second one, Mansa. Mansa, is there? Hello?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you please repeat that?
I have not given any topic right now. I wanted to have two volunteers. The topic is a bit different. And with you, Raghu is there. Raghu, can you please unmute yourself?
Yes, Umesh.
Yeah. I'm going to give one scene. And the characters I'm going to define, you have to enact within 2 minutes. Timer, we will give 30 seconds to them to think on that situation. And they will do the role play with the characters. Is that okay? Is this clear?
Okay.
Mansa?
Yeah, okay.
Only twist is that because Umesh is there and twist is not there. Aisa ho nahi sakta. So twist is that the male character will be played by female and female character will be played by male. Now, is that okay?
I don't know who Umesh is.
Yeah, but now your table topic master has chosen you. So let's start because I like your voice quality, facial expressions. Now I want to see in a female version. So topic is being a husband and wife. Wife is giving opportunity to husband that please give some time to look after our children. And at least at the weekend, focus and give some wise advices so that weekdays will be better for me in absence of you. Is that clear? The situation is clear. Mansa, you will be playing husband role and wife will be Raghu.
Can I just say some things?
Yes.
I'm just 20. I really don't know how husband reacts and all.
Okay. Okay. What I suggest, Mansa, I will give you, if it is okay with you, there are husband and wife, both. We are lucky to have both in the room. So I will ask Kalpana to join as a husband. Is that okay, Mansa? Next topic.
Yeah, that
I will
sounds
give you.
Better. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
So can someone assist me for the just noting the time? Okay, I will do on my clock and I will say 1 minute 30 seconds and 2. Is that okay? Okay, Kalpana, please unmute yourself.
Hello.
So everyone is ready. Shout.
Okay.
To have. So 30 seconds for thinking. Already I have given more than 30 seconds.
It's so Sunday. Sunday. What you do is only eat idli dosa and then just sit there in the Toastmaster meeting. You say Brazil, you say United States, and then you say Hyderabad entrepreneurs, United entrepreneurs. What is this? At least give some time for the kids.
Come on, what's wrong? You know, I am improving in communication and kids are also learning seeing me and I'm sitting quiet. You should celebrate because I'm quiet. I'm not asking you to make bhaji, pakoda and all. I'm just taking a water bottle and whatever you are giving, I'm eating on my desk and sitting here. How does it bother you? Come on, Kalpana.
What is the use of going and blabbering in different countries when you cannot even take care of your kids at home? If you keep loading me all the time with kids and then work in the kitchen and then my office work, what do you think?
Come on, that's the reason I made you also Toastmaster and I ensured that you also get busy with Toastmasters and I added kids into Gavalier Club. What else you need? I gave you each one of you one laptop and so that you can attend your own meetings. We have 4 different rooms, sit in 4 different classes.
Stop. I joined Toastmaster because I can take my revenge on you through my speeches. That's why I'm going to give a speech in different contests saying how you are torturing me. I've seen people giving speeches how their wives are torturing them and they're winning humorous speech contests. Now I'm going to take the revenge by telling how useless the husbands are.
No problem. I am your mentor and I can give you all the speech approvals and also don't remember.
No. I don't need. I'm the super mentor. I'm multi-talented.
that doesn't matter. I am the senior Toastmaster here, and I am a worldwide, and two DTMs also. You don't even have one.
Just a Toastmaster. Umesh, what do you have to say about it?
It's a wonderful treat to watch. I'm turning on my video for a few seconds. Thank you, Kalpana, and thank you, Raghu. Raghu, I was expecting a voice modulation, facial expressions, which I used to see. So I will not, I'm giving straightforward feedback to you. Kalpana is better than you as a husband.
As wife also, I am only better than him. Don't worry.
All and I just to say about never debate. One wise advice given by one of my friend from UK, from Stafford. When there was clashes between me and my wife, I am working in Aurangabad. I remember this incidents just now. That she said, never debate with woman. First thing. Whatever she says, she is always right. And if she is your wife, then forget what you say. She is always right. So this is a just hint. Whosoever is wise, they will take this hint and move forward. So I would like to call upon the next speaker. Mansa, would you like to go?
This will be the last topic, Umesh, in the respect. Time, it will be last topic.
Okay. Mansa, you are ready or? Hello.
Mansa, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, Umesh, you can go ahead and do the topic.
Okay. Toastmaster Mansa, continuous improvement is better than delayed perfection. Continuous improvement is better than delayed perfection. Toastmaster Mansa, over to you.
Yeah, I feel continuous. Can you please repeat that statement again? Sorry.
Continuous improvement is better than delayed perfection.
Yeah, I feel continuous improvement is way better than delayed perfection, because I feel not everyone is perfect in everything. So it takes time for someone to realize on what things, you know, they are concentrating on or something. Not everyone, you know, they get perfection easily. So I feel when you constantly work on something, when you constantly keep thinking on something, you get things perfect in such a way. I think there are many things. There are many things like, you know, there are many proverbs based on this also. Suddenly, I don't remember them. Slow and steady win the race and all these things. Sorry if I sound wrong. Yeah, I feel when you do some things, you know, with a lot of clarity and with the clearance and everything, so you might get, you know, you might get success easily. But then, you know, mistakes also, sometimes the mistakes which you attempt or sometimes the wrongdoings and everything, you know, you'll be corrected automatically with all the mistakes you keep doing every day. So in everything. So I feel, you know, there are few things like, you know, failure or the stepping stones to success or something. Yeah, there are few proverbs based on this also. So I feel, one shouldn't feel backward or one shouldn't feel humiliated just because they are being failed in everything or something. But everything, whatever you do, whatever effort you put in, maybe it takes time for you to reach your destination. Or I think everyone should be really determined enough and everyone should be really patient enough to reach their position. And then in your midway or in your way, you might face many things. You might face hurdles. You might face many things. But then I think everyone should be very patient, and they should never give up on whatever they are doing. Maybe it takes time, little time, more than they expect. But then at one day or at one point or on one day, you'll definitely reach that. And I feel a lot of improvement or something, I think this thing is very, very important for everyone to remember. So continuous improvement is very, very needed for everyone. I think it is more important than this delayed perfection. Yeah.
Thank you, Toastmaster Mansa, for your views. And you, as rightly said, continuous improvement is always better. And we should not never, ever give up on our goals. Whatever may be the failures, we should work on. And I remember one word. We should unleash the powers within to find the better version of us every next day. So that was thing. And sometimes you feel that I am a perfect or the whatever I did perfect. But from other perspective, that might not be perfect thing. So whatever the definition of perfection is different. And delaying things for the perfection could hamper or could lost the opportunities through continuous improvement. The last topic I would like to give to Toastmaster, just I would like to pronounce it correctly.
If for the benefit of everybody, it is Claudimir.
Claudimir. Toastmaster Claudimir, would you like to go for next topic?
Sure. I'm sorry, I was mute.
Are you ready?
I'm ready, yeah.
Toastmaster Claudimir, feedback is the breakfast of champions. Feedback is the breakfast of champions.
Yes. Thank you for the question, fellow Toastmasters and guests, to be here again. Yes, feedback is the key foundation for any improvement. Myself, I had difficulties to understand the feedback at the beginning of my career. And that was because my former manager didn't know how to give a feedback, a proper feedback. He always took things personally. And that was really hard for me. And the way he gave me feedback really caused me a lot of problems because I thought I was the baddest person in the world, and that was not true. The problem was that he didn't know how to give it. And then over time, I learned that feedback is the most important thing. But more than that is the way we give. It should be constructive, it should be honest, it should be transparent. And if you really want to help someone, you have to give feedback. But if you don't feel that you are going to help someone, don't give it. Only give if you want to help someone from the heart. That is what I think. And sometimes it's hard, I know, because we have blind spots, but it's very important for our development. And we have to be open to that. Thank you so much for the opportunity.
Thank you, Toastmaster Claudimir. You rightly said feedback is the key. And the way we give the feedback is most important. The feedback should be constructive, honest, and transparent. And main thing, there should be emotion that to whosoever we are giving feedback, we should have in mind that it's going to help him. Then only that can be effective feedback. The way you narrated your story, just I remember one of my incidents. One of my manager was not able to give the feedback in an appropriate way. And I was achieving my all KPIs, but still there was a conflict between us. But somehow, someone has to step back. I took a step back and I did take that feedback for the next KPI as an improvement. And after that, he found that, yes, I could give this feedback in a better way. Just giving the negative comments or rather not accepting that the person is achieving the KPIs. So good to know that if we give the feedback in appropriate way, that will help others. And if you receive feedback in a constructive, honest, and transparent way, we will also improve. Thank you for your views. Timer. Hello.
All the speakers
timer, Kalpana,
are,
may I have?
Yes, yes. All the speakers are qualified for voting and we can launch the poll.
Yeah.
I will share the details in the chat.
Okay. I request Zoom Master to launch the poll. Everyone are requested to vote.
Toastmaster Rubali seems to be missing from the polls.
Even Raghu's name.
Yeah, I didn't put my name. Wonderly. I'll.
Raghu is disqualified by Table Topic Master.
1 minute. I'll relaunch the poll, adding the Rupali's name.
Raghu, you can add your name. Thank you. Hope everyone has given their opinion for the best table topic speaker. Timer, can I continue with my conclusion remark?
Yes.
We need two more votes. Please vote. No problem. I think I have the winner.
Okay. Thank you for giving me this opportunity and listening and initial phase, there was a 2 or 3 times network issue. I disconnected. Again, I joined. So my apologies for that. But remember, never ever give up. Have feedback from others. Work on the feedback that will be beneficial for your growth only. And when you are in the position to help someone by giving feedback, definitely give feedback with true, honest, and transparency and with your whole heart. And not just for sake of giving feedback. And as an evaluator, I'm looking forward for the best feedback for today's speeches. Thank you, everyone. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Umesh, for that very interesting round of table topics. Let us give him a big round of applause. Yeah, thank you. Considering the time, I just want to conclude the topic by stating why feedback is important. A few points I listed out and I want to mention those. The first one is feedback keeps everyone on track. Feedbacks help you, your team avoid major mistakes. And the next one is you form better relationships. Constructive feedback motivates people. Feedback promotes personal and professional growth. Feedback helps to create a friendly work environment. Feedback produces some business related direct benefits. And we all taking feedback is one step and giving feedback is another step. So the skill of providing feedback. So first we need to avoid anything that can be heard as blaming or judging. We want to motivate people and show them areas for improvement, not the opposite. And make sure we, while giving feedback, make sure we are specific and use evidence. And we need to give people time to understand the feedback and make sure to receive their responses. And don't forget to let them be part of the problem-solving process. It is not uncommon that people are not actually sure what happened or what their next step should be. That's why we should ask questions in the end and see if the other person received the message we want to deliver in the form of our feedback. Last but not least, encourage team members to provide feedback as well. Leave your ego behind. Ask them if they have something to add about your performance and role as a manager or when you are performing anywhere. And carefully listen to what they have to say and what they are saying. Let them give examples too, so you can see what exactly they mean. Like they ask you to change or improve. Then discuss this openly and together to find a way to make it work and use the feedback effectively. I always remember, if someone is giving me a feedback, they want me to improve. They want me to step ahead in my life. So let us take the feedback as constructive, and let's be positive and take the feedback and improve ourselves. Thank you. We now begin with the evaluation session. To conduct the session, we have Toastmaster Nikhila. Over to you, Nikhila.
Thank you, Shweta. We will start with the evaluation process. I request Bhavini, Toastmaster Bhavini, to submit her report of Cladimers, Toastmaster Cladimers. Over to you, Bhavini.
Am I clearly audible and visible? I can see the timer cards. Right. Toastmaster Cladimer, let me begin by saying that you deserve a plaudit for sharing such an engaging story. We all have a background story of how we ended up joining this wonderful international organization of Toastmasters. And by sharing your own story, it made it quite relatable. And I was engrossed all the time. But what I also loved is how you came into an audience amongst Indians today, and you also shattered a misconception that most of the Indians have, that people outside of India have it easy when it comes to English speaking. And I think that was also a very strong message and example that came out to me. Your delivery, it was very difficult to believe that at one point in your life you struggled with speaking English fluently, because I saw a very calm, composed, and a very fluent speaker in front of me today. Your pace of speech delivery was as easy as it can get, and the usage of sentence construction, the way they were formed, was also quite easy to understand and follow. Your gesticulation was also appropriate, coupled with that sly smile whenever we lie to someone. So that was also a great touch of delivery. But what stood out to me is how you used the hand to mask the camera and tell about a transition of 10 years. So that was quite innovative and intelligent, I felt. Now, all of these were the glow points of your speech. And now let's see the grow points of your speech. And I have two for you. Number one, remember, every speech, the beginning 30 to 40 seconds are very crucial, which is called the opening of a speech, something that strikes the audience, and it decides whether for the rest of the time the audience is going to stay with you or not. So your story started and it went up till the conclusion. I would recommend you that the speech has an introduction. So what you could have done is you could have started with a question, perhaps in this case. Ladies and gentlemen, do you all have something that you wish to do, but you never pursued it just because you thought that it was too late? Then this story is for you. And then you could have started your story, right? And the second recommendation I have for you is to have a very impactful conclusion. Remember what you say in the last with the audience. Once you're done with your intro and body, which had a very great message, that it is never too late to start. That message could have come screaming at us. Like you could have said, did you always wish to join Zumba classes? Did you always wish to join, you know, visit a particular destination? What are you waiting for? It is never too late. Join that class tomorrow. Book your tickets now. So that could have been quite impactful and something that would have invoked a call to action amongst your listeners. So overall, it was a great speech. I commend you for your excellent message, your excellent delivery. And with this two pillars of introduction, a striking introduction and an impactful conclusion, you can take your story up a notch. Thank you. Over to you and all the best.
Thank you, Bhavani. I request Rupali to come and give her report for Raghu, Toastmaster.
Thank you, General Evaluator. Toastmaster Raghu, the way you started your speech was by telling a story about Mahatma Gandhi. And I must tell you, the minute I listened the word Mahatma, we all got, you succeeded to got our attention. And you told us that how a person should first experience and then try to suggest something. And that story was very impactful. I must say that human lives or even living things has a time limit and it ends after some time. However, the stories we transfer or share remains immortal. And hence, I would say the story which you delivered through your entire speech made me realize that this is what I can take back with me from this meeting. I really like the way you shared a smile on your face consistently throughout your speech. It made me feel that you are very confident, happy about your speech, and very comfortable to deliver it. And why not? Because you shared your entire experience of being a leader and how you build the trust with your team members, how a leader should actually, the leader shows the way, however, how their team members will follow. So you actually need to build the trust. So you showed how you did it and how we can learn to master it. Then you shared the story with your mother. And I believe the transition between your these experiences were something which is very impactful. Like the ability to share a story with the audience was engaging and entertaining at the same time. Your entire speech was had a very nice help with your gestures and vocal variety, and the expressions with your eyes caught my attention. Like wherever you were emphasizing a point, your eyes were large enough to express that yes, that the trust should be trust is important in the leadership quality. Then I would just like to suggest two things to manage the time, because I think the speech was up to the time. However, you just almost end up with the red flag. So you could have done better with management of time. Like you could have speed up when you see the yellow card. And you told us the story, but I would just, I feel that it could have been better if you add some quote on it to support your story. And that's it. That's all what I felt. And thank you for the speech. I have learned a lot. Over to the General Evaluator.
Thank you, Rupali.
I request our counter to submit her report. TM Indira. Indira?
Yeah. Thank you, General Evaluator. Sweta used the word so, and Nikhila had Manasa used the word so. So that's all for me. And other participants are no filler word. Back to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Indira. I request Manasa, grammarian of the day, to submit her report.
Toastmaster Bhavni Kangar used the word of the day. And then when it comes to the grammar, not a correction. Yeah, instead of if we have a time, we can also use if time permits, because sentence looks good when we use kind of these things. So instead of excellent and good, you know, make use of words like splendid or magnificent, because sentence looks good if you make use of that. And if you make use of, if you make less usage of adverbs like which ends with ly and all, it looks better. So instead of using fear, scare, you know, it's better to use petrify, terrify, so that it looks different. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Manasa. I request Timer Kalpana to submit her report.
General Evaluator. Speaker 1, Vladimir, used taken 5 minutes 28 seconds. Speaker 2, Distinguished Toastmaster Raghu, took 7 minutes 25 seconds. Table topic speaker Bhavini took 2 minutes 20 seconds. Toastmaster Nikhila took 1 minute 21 seconds. Guest Kiran took 1 minute 46 seconds. Toastmaster Indira took 1 minute 1 second. Guest Subhadra took 1 minute 50 seconds. Toastmaster Rupali took 1 minute 45 seconds. Raghu and Kalpana together took 2 minutes 15 seconds. Toastmaster Manasa took 2 minutes 30 seconds. And Toastmaster Vladimir took 1 minute 46 seconds. In the evaluation segment, Toastmaster Bhavini took 3 minutes 29 seconds. And Toastmaster Rupali took 3 minutes 15 seconds. That's all from my end. Thank you. Over to the General Evaluator.
Thank you, Kalpana. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day, Shweta.
Nikhila, you need to give few of your observations.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, thank you, Raghu. So I loved that theme today, constructive feedback, which is really important in progressing on our lives. And I loved the way Shweta presented that topic by adding her real life experiences, by making it more engaging by asking questions in between. So I loved the way she presented it. And coming to speeches, I loved both the speeches, and I can more relate to Vladimir's because my father used to push me to learn English when I was a child, even though I didn't, I was like Vladimir at that time, so I didn't much acted on it. Now I realized and I took that action, which is also relate to that never too late. And coming to Raghu's speech, I was impressed by that topic, like how important it is in integrity in our life, and how he took the responsibility of his team members. I learned a great thing, like a very important thing in life. Being a leader is to take the responsibility to be integrable. And I also understood how empathy is important by when he told about his mother, and also the example he had given about his mentor. So I loved both the speeches. And coming to Table Topics Master, I loved the touch Umesh added to Table Topics Master by giving that enact. I really enjoyed it because the reversal of roles, it reminded me of one movie. It's a Telugu movie, Jambalakadi Pamba. In childhood, I don't know how many times I watched it. So reversing of roles, it just struck. So yeah, wonderful topic, Umesh. Thank you very much. And
all speakers, all guests and speakers have delivered good table topic speeches. And evaluators also, they did a best job, even both Rupali and Bhavini. Yeah, that's it from my side. Thank you. Over to you, Shruti.
Yeah, I think at this point of time. Yeah, Shruti, go ahead.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nikhila, for an excellent evaluation session. I will end by sharing my how I feel the session. Actually, till now I attended so many Toastmaster clubs, but nowhere I found a single Telugu speaking person. And here I am more comfortable, and basically I am a Hyderabadi. I felt before joining the meeting, I felt it will be easy for me to communicate, but I was wrong. This is nowhere less than an international meeting. And I found everyone enthusiastic, everything is constructive, and I saw the perfection in the meeting. Really, very perfect. Very, very perfect. And I took so many inputs from this club, like how to organize, what are the rules you're following, how you're structuring everything. And I will try to implement. And by listening your stories, the way you spoke in table topics, everything, it add something in my life. And today I'm carrying something valuable. Thank you, everyone. I have the most entertaining session, and I thoroughly enjoyed being the Toastmaster of the day. I now hand over control of meeting to our president for the award ceremony and the closing address. Over to you, President. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster of the day, for the wonderful theme, so that we can cover why feedback is essential, and you just added the personal experiences. Kudos, good job. I would like to call Toastmaster Raghu, the Zoom master for today, to please announce the results.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Kalpana. Let me share the results just to maintain. The speaker goes to me. But just one point, but then Claudimus, which was great too, people love the speech. Now, coming to best TT speaker. Best TT speaker for today is Toastmaster Claudimus. People love your table topic speech, Claudimus. Thank you very much for joining us today. Now, best speech evaluator. It's an anonymous Toastmaster Bhavani. You again give a bang on this evaluation. I grab this speech. Thank you very much. This, whether you win or not, it doesn't matter. What matters is, are you able to make that change? As one of the topics given by Toastmaster Umesh, what matters is, are you making those small, taking those small steps. Perfection, there is no perfection. That's what I keep hearing from all seniors, even in speech or anything in life. That is the reason why the world is moving towards agile, which means smaller goals. And you work towards a bigger goal in your life. Just do that, pick up something that you want to improve and work upon it. That is what matters. Moving ahead matters. That is the reason the rabbit and tortoise. Rabbit just stopped at a point, but the tortoise made the gradual movement, and it, the consistency helped it to win the race. So what matters. Thank you. I pass the control back to the presiding officer. Just before that, can I request everybody to keep your video on so that we can have a colleague add photo. to keep your video on and give a wide smile. Indira, Umesh, Indira, Manasa, if possible, please. Subhadra, if possible. 1, 2, 3, and the chief.
I request everyone to just show hearts for such wonderful meeting in your, so that it will be.
Can we take one more? 1, 2, 3. Say cheese. Thank you very much. Back to you, Madam President. Okay. President has dropped due to technical issue. As a VP education of the club, I adjourn the meeting officially. You can stay back for networking. Thank you. And I'll start the recording at this point.